Everybody knows, but we are against the prison in our neighborhood or close to our neighborhood. First of all, I know it's Governor Ivy and all, but y'all can stop any building permit. I mean, there's not, you know, after doing research on it, it's not giving jobs to Bibb County or Briarfield. And we, a lot of us are senior citizens, and we love our, what, white neighborhood, safe neighborhood, and a prison will destroy that. It's been proven, more violence comes in. And I just read an article in Montgomery Advertiser, they're closing other prisons to build these three new ones, and those people will lose their jobs. They're not going to have as many correction officers. So that's a scam there. But I just, please do not give them permits to build the prison. So that's it.
Next up is Chris Nelson.
Good evening, gentlemen. My name is Randall Finley. I live at 18680 Highway 139 in Briarfield, Alabama, and I'm here this evening to also speak on the subject of the prison in Briarfield. I only have a few brief points I'd like to make, as I only have 5 minutes, otherwise I'll be here for 5 weeks. My first concern is the environmental and historical impact on Briarfield. Briarfield, Alabama is one of the most historical sites in the state. It's one of the last skirmishes of the Civil War that led to our freedom and the freedom of those that were enslaved. There's many sites in Briarfield that's going to be bulldozed over if they haven't already by the voice of North America. My second point would be the environmental impact of Mahan Creek and Shoal Creek. Mahan Creek and Shoal Creek joined together to form the Little Cahaba that then forms the Big Cahaba. That comes out of Birmingham. Those two water sites, those two waterways, have been deemed the cleanest water sources in the state of Alabama for the water. It's government record. Let's leave it that way. Third, inmates. Our prison system needs reform from the inside, not the outside. Building a new building will do nothing other than make it look more pretty. The inmates in the state prison system, their mental health care is deplorable. That should be addressed before anything else. If you wanna cut down on violence and crime in the prisons, well, then we should be advocating to change a few laws that are just stacking them in there like cordwood, and we should also try to get them some more help. My last request is the safety and security of Brock. I leave that for last, because Brock has always been kind of a little community, kind of handles its own. And when the sheriff's office has to come, it's pretty bad. And I would personally ask this, if we can't beat this prison, I'd like to see the sheriff's office, their staff, doubled in size, and I would like to see their budget quadrupled. Before EMA and Briarfield is non-existent, you provided us with a Bibb alert system that I can get an app on my phone. Well, gentlemen, I'm here to tell you today, at 1-868 Highway 139 Briarfield, there's not a cell phone in the state that'll have service. So your tornado warning system does not alert me at all, or anyone here. I think that should be addressed before we address the prison. If, you know, as a citizen of Briarfield, I kind of feel like I'm being run over. You know, that I just learned yesterday evening, by walking a public road to a piece of Board of Education property in Briarfield, that many people here probably don't know the Board of Education is property in Briarfield. Only there to find a sign that's been put up by ADEM with a permit number for La Hoist America, which has bought property and extended its operation to directly behind the fire department. The drone footage shows that they have dug a catch pit for water runoff, and that's what the permit said. What are they building there? Why is anyone here not notified us of this? This is less than an eighth of a mile from my front door. I can already hear the bulldozers at night, clank, 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 all night long. And I can see Stone Mountain, is what we call it now. Yeah. I can see it above the tree line in Briarfield. What an eyesore. Are we more concerned about money in this county, or are we more concerned about people? I've always loved Bibb County. My heart is in Bibb County. But when you feel like you're being beat by your own people, it might be time to go. I will always commend the sheriff's office for the job they do. They've always responded promptly, and they put the heart into everything they do. They're the most overworked and underpaid men in the state of Alabama. And having been former law enforcement, retired law enforcement, I understand what they do and what they go through. But we don't have any service from them in Briarfield other than one or two guys at night. That's ridiculous. Anybody's ever had to fight someone that's strong and big, it takes more than two. And one of my people getting shot across this nation for no reason? 1,000 wounds that haven't happened to us already this year. And I'll leave it at that. But let's just think about the environmental impact. Has ADEM been notified? What is their take on it? What about the EPA? I know that several private, non-for-profit environmental organizations that I've contacted are wanting to get involved. And they're involved. So we're going to have support on that matter, either way it goes, because Briarfield's a beautiful place, and I intend to keep it that way. Thank you.
Public comment about elections, please.
Roll call. Commissioner Burke?